Well, it looks like Amy Coney Barrett is in the lead as of tonight, and that may change as this administration's Supreme Court nominee. We remember what happened to the last nominee, Kavanaugh. They called him a gang rapist. How will Democrats top that? Well, you may have given us a preview 3 years ago when Amy Coney Barrett was nominated to the appellate bench. At the time, Democrats grilled her for being Catholic. So then that's about as bad as being a gang rapist. Watch.
I think whatever a religion is, it has its own dogma. The law is totally different. And I think in your case, Professor, when you read your speeches, the conclusion one draws is that the dogma lives loudly within you. And that's of concern.
The dogma lives loudly in you. Well, first of all, that's illiterate. It doesn't mean anything, not surprising from Dianne Feinstein. But more broadly, the question is, would Feinstein say that to any other person of faith? Imagine Dianne Feinstein saying that to a Muslim nominee. Yeah, you can't imagine that. At the same hearing, Senator Dick Durbin also pressed Barrett on her faith, believe it or not. Watch this.
Do you consider yourself an Orthodox Catholic?
I am a Catholic, Senator Durbin. But if you're asking whether I take my faith seriously and I'm a faithful Catholic, I am, although I would stress that my personal church affiliation or my religious belief would not bear on the discharge of my duties as a judge.
Can you even imagine? But needless to say, our media faithfully echoed these Democratic Party attacks, as they always do. One headline written by a political activist posing as a reporter in the wire service Reuters read this way, quote, "Handmaid's Tale, U.S. Supreme Court's religious community under scrutiny." Reuters later edited that headline. We'll see what happens if Amy Coney Barrett gets the nomination, but we think we have a template for what they're going to do to her. Steve Krakauer is watching carefully. He's an editor of the Fourth Watch newsletter and podcast. We're happy to have him on the show tonight. Steve, thanks so much for coming on. It's hard to believe that the media would attack a nominee's religious faith in 2020, but do you think they will?
Well, yeah, I don't think that there's this group of, you know, militant atheists in the media who are trying to rid the world of religion. I think it's very much, you know, more about this there's a laziness to it, I think, but there's also obviously an ignorance to it. There was an article in NPR about Joe Biden only on Sunday, how Joe Biden's faith informs his politics. And let me tell you, they think it informs his politics in a very positive way. He's got rosary and he's going to church every Sunday. That's a good thing. But they start with this chicken or egg thing, right? They like Joe Biden's politics, and so because of that, the faith is a good thing. But they don't like Amy Coney Barrett, and so her faith all of a sudden is scary and weird, and they're going to go and attack that way.
What's interesting is that Amy Coney Barrett, from what we know of her, follows the precepts of the Catholic Church much more closely than Joe Biden does, particularly on the question of abortion. So, but that it's bad when she takes her faith seriously, but good when Joe Biden doesn't. But to my original question, is any other faith at risk of being mocked the way Christianity is by our media?
I'm not sure. I think that you mentioned, you know, Islam. I think that there would certainly be an enormous pushback if the media did anything like they're doing about the Christian faith, like the Muslim faith, like they're doing about the Christian faith. You know, I'm not sure if a Jewish judge who happened to be conservative and a Trump support, you know, a Trump nominated judge would be out there. I'm not sure that the media would hold back if they felt that there was some sort of, it was the inspiration for this scary Handmaid's Tale, which, by the way, I think that also speaks to the laziness of this. You know, The Handmaid's Tale was written in 1985. There wasn't a whole lot of like Handmaid's Tale analogies from 1985 to 2017, but as soon as it was streaming on Hulu, everything is this scary Handmaid's Tale. And honestly, it's not even an actual inspiration for the book, which is what the Newsweek column said, which is what the Reuters article was based on. It actually was People of Hope that was there was some clipping that was found by Margaret Atwood. It was not even the right sect of Christianity that they're talking about that they supposedly inspired this scary, you know, show that they're watching on Hulu.
Yeah, the fact that they're watching that, some weird feminist fever dream about the patriarchy, I mean, it just tells you everything. It's miserable people. Steve Krakauer, great to see you tonight. Thank you.
Thanks, Tucker.